teacher, Polymer Clay Tutor, and today's studio tip is Renaissance Wax. Now, this is a new product that I am currently in love with. It's probably my favorite finish for getting a shiny, glossy look on polymer clay. Now, the reason why I love it is that it's easy to apply, it gets a nice, beautiful gloss, and it's just... It's just so easy. There's no drips. There's no wait time. There's no dry time. It's just really easy to work with and beautiful finish. Now, let me just show you what it looks like on some little butterfly beads. Now, here is a little butterfly bead that I've put the wax on, and you can see it's just gleamy and shiny and beautiful. I'll show you the difference between, here's one here, where I've put the wax on one side and I didn't put the wax on this side, and you can see this side is quite matte finished. That's how it came out of the oven. And on this side it's all shiny and glossy. Now, sometimes, you know, like, you know that I love to sand and buff things to a high shine and not even put a finish on. But on projects like this, on these little beads where you've got a lot of sculpture, and especially anything that has a finish on it, like gold leaf or silver leaf or pearl X powder or something like that, where you can't sand it or it's difficult to sand, it is great to put a finish on it to protect it or give it a nice shiny look. But there's so many different finishes out there, and I am really starting to find that most of the liquids are more hassle than they are benefit. A wax like this, now this is a specialty wax that's made in England actually, and it was designed for the galleries to use. Now it's a UV protector. You can put it on absolutely any finish and without harming it. You can put it on paintings, and that's what they do in galleries. They put it on wood, plastics, fabrics, paper. They've even used Renaissance wax for things like really precious photographs that they're worried about breaking down by UV light. You can put this wax onto anything you're worried about getting fingerprints on, or oils, or it works beautifully on metals. So you can put it on like a copper pot or copper jewelry and it won't tarnish. You can use it on steel and it won't rust. It's just an amazing product. And it's a microcrystalline wax. And it comes in a little tub. I believe you can buy great big giant tubs of it. It's relatively expensive, but not in the long run. It's about $16 or so. I bought mine at Fry. I'm not sure how you pronounce that. But you can also get it at places like Polymer Clay Express and other places online. It comes with this little pamphlet that just talks about the wonders of it and how it's used and where it was designed and everything. It's just a really neat product, but it's super easy to use. So I'll just show you on this little dragonfly bead where I didn't coat these two wings here. And you can just use a soft cloth or a piece of paper towel and you just wipe it on. And like I said, it seems expensive for a little container, but it goes forever and ever and ever and ever. So it, in the long run, it's not expensive at all. So I just got a little bit onto my towel here, paper towel, and you just wipe it on. And it dries really quickly. It makes a very hard, clear surface that dries really quickly, and you can wipe it on. It works beautifully on, you know, surfaces like this that are kind of tricky to get a nice glaze on. Then you just let it dry for a minute or so, and then you can just buff it right up. And oh, it looks to me like it's kind of gone matte, so that should be dry. So I can just start buffing this up. And you can add more layers if you like. It's not quite dry enough yet. Anyways, I'll just keep going. And as it starts to dry, it buffs right up to a beautiful shine. And you can add more more layers if you want to get it super glossy. Much easier than putting on a liquid finish, don't you think? So my question is, would you use a wax like this for surfaces instead of a liquid? Or do you prefer to use like something like a gloss finish, that kind of thing? And would you pay, you know, the $15 for a little container or not? If this was helpful for you, make sure to press that like button. That would be great. And you feel free to share this with whoever you like. And if you have any comments or questions, please leave them in the comment section below. So I hope that you enjoyed that, and I will see you next time. Bye for now.